Okay, students, as in the last class we have discussed about the accounting for share capital. In that we have seen the definition of the company. Okay, in that features of the company, which are the features we get from the company, that we have seen. In that specifically the body corporate, separate legal entity, then limited liability, perpetual succession, common seal, transferability of the shares, and lastly the may sue or may be sued. These are the features which we got from the definition of the accounting itself. Then further we saw the kinds of companies on the basis of the liabilities. Also three types of companies are there. On the basis of number of members also we have seen three types are there. So further in today's class what we are going to discuss is share capital of a company. See, obviously while starting the chapter itself from this second part of the book, we in the accountancy we were dealing with the heading calling as a accounting for share capital is the first chapter. But in the name of the book itself, company accounts and analysis of the financial statement, what we have seen, it is related to the finance and the company. Now in the company you are not one person to invest and run. Okay, here every persons come together, gather and put the amount means purchase the equity shares of the company and gather the amount at one place, and that amount is nothing but the share capital. Okay, here in the share capital what exactly we mean to say is a company being an artificial person, we can't see the company, it is an artificial person, cannot generate its own capital. As a company naming Reliance Company, by saying itself the capital cannot fall from up, someone has to come from outside and collect the amount, gather the amount, that time it forms the capital. That is one thing you will know from it. So a company being an artificial person cannot generate its own capital. It cannot generate its own capital, remember, then which has necessarily to be collected from several people. Now one person will not have that much huge amount of capital. So for that purpose we collect it from the several persons. The several persons are known as shareholders. The several persons from the people we collect the money, that people are called the shareholders. And the amount contributed by the shareholders is called as a share capital. It is what the definition. How easily you understand it, that can be remembered. Okay, in the starting, company being an artificial person, it cannot generate its own capital. It cannot generate its own capital. So it is necessary to collect from several people or persons. Several people or persons we have to collect it. That these people are called as shareholders. The shareholders which amount they contribute is called as share capital. This is what the simple definition of share capital of a company. See, a share capital of the company is what? A company has being an artificial person cannot generate its own capital. It cannot generate own capital, cannot be generated, which has necessarily to be collected. What it can we do? It can be collected from several people. Which are the several people? We don't know. Those who are interested to invest in the business, these are the persons. Then these persons are known as shareholders. The persons who are unknown, those who are interested to invest in our business, are none other than the shareholders. Then, and the amount of contributed by them is called the people, the shareholders, which amount they are contributing is nothing but share capital. Till here is the definition. Then further, we will be having here the categories of share capital. Now, first we came to know what is share capital, but how we form a shares, that matters here a lot. How we are going to form, how we are going to collect here the shares. Here we are having categories of share capital. Categories of share capital. Which of categories are there? We will see. First is authorized. Authorized capital. Authorized capital. Okay. Then next is subscribed. Subscribed capital. Then one more. Issued capital. Actually, this is interchange. The second point is this. Okay. Then next one is called up. Called up capital. Next, paid up capital. Uncalled capital. Then reserve capital. This many categories of shareholders are there. So one by one we will see here. Now coming across these words, categories of a share capital, from accounting point of view, what from the accounting point of view, the share capital of the company can be classified in this way. From accounting point of view, as we are dealing with the subject accountancy, these points are the, these are the categories where we collect a share capital. Okay. Now exactly we know that what is share capital. Now further we are going to see how we are going to collect the share capital. First point says that authorized capital. Now what is this authorized capital? It means, see, authorized capital is the amount of share capital which a company is authorized to issue under memorandum of association. See, when you are starting a business or a firm or a company, that time two things in secretarial practice subject we are going to get: two forms, memorandum of association and articles of association. When you fill this, that time only your company will be framed or formed. Okay, that things should be remembered. Okay, this is out of this concept, but how you form a business or company, that things are to be known. Now this, what this memorandum of association or articles of association contains, these are the conditions framed by the government or the Companies Act 2013. So and so things has to be done. The rules, policies, programs framed by them. What all things has to be done, that will be mentioned there. So in the authorized capital means what? While signing down the memorandum of association, the company will be told to collect this much amount of capital. Means you are going to tell them what is your budget. Now your budget is 1 crore. Okay. Now how you are going to collect? In what form? Through the shares. In the shares, you are going to give the applications, then subscriptions you have to make. These are the ways. Now, first thing you need to know is how much you are going to, how much you require, that much only you can collect at in the starting. Directly you don't require 1 crore. You may require 70 lakhs at starting to run the business. Then remaining 30 lakhs keep the balance and call, make a final call for them. Okay, make a final call for this. At once, you cannot collect whole amount here. As per the memorandum of association, what you are going to mention there, the same things has to be followed. As per your requirement, you have to call up the amount. You cannot call at once or more than that. You can't call more than that. If you are required 1 crore and few more, if you like 10 lakhs more to collect, you can't collect this as per the conditions framed by the memorandum of association. Here what it happens, I will tell you. Authorized capital is the amount of share capital which a company is authorized, means company is authorized to collect at that extent only, okay, to issue by its memorandum of association. The company cannot raise more than the amount of capital as specified in the memorandum of association. Now in the memorandum of association, they have told we require 1 crore of amount. They can't collect single rupee more than this 1 crore. Not even single rupee they can collect from more than from this amount. That is what the conditions framed in the memorandum of association. Then further, it is also called as this authorized is also called as registered capital also, and one more nominal or registered. Capital. Another alternative names for it. Even they may say that authorized capital also may be called as a registered capital also. While the registration, you will be giving them the budget so that we in 1 crore we are going to start up with the business. Now the question arises, you are calling only 1 crore amount. You can't cross limits and collect this extra amount. How we are collecting? It will be by subscription, then issuing the capital and call up and final call. These further points are there. You will come to know exactly what it is. But this point, authorized capital means what? As per the authority, what you have written in the memorandum of association, at that extent only you can collect the capital. Not single 1 rupee more you can't collect there. That is what the first point. Authorized capital. Now coming to the second, issued capital. Now issued capital means what you are going to know. Now it is part of this issued capital. These points are there, you know, further this one here. It is part of this. Part of authorized capital. This is what? The part of authorized capital. Issued capital is nothing but a part of authorized capital. What it means, I will tell you. It is that part of authorized capital which is actually issued to the public for subscription, including the shares allotted to the vendors and the signatories of the company's memorandum. The authorized capital which are not offered for the public subscription is known as issued capital. Now see, now out of this, now how you are going to collect through the shares? Okay, I will tell you all. Now till now, how your company starts proceeding, you can call issue shares of rupees 10 each. Okay, 10 each if you are issuing. No one said that whole of the 10 rupees you have to call at once only. You can call up, that is what called up capital. Next point, you can call up 7 rupees called up capital. Then remaining 3 rupees when you require, that time you can call. Okay, how your requirement is there, in that way you can call up the capital. Simply taking the capital and keep storing with you, is it usable? No. How much you are utilizing, how much you require, that much call up the capital, and remaining keep as a unissued capital. Whenever we require unissued, two wordings are there here. See, in the issued capital, two wordings. One is the issued and unissued. Issued means what? Out of this, each share contains 10 rupees. Out of this, how much you have called up and how much you have kept reserved for further. At once only you are not going to, or at once only it is not required the whole amount. However your requirements come, you can call up the capital. That is what exactly we are going to know from this chapter and this concept, categories of share capital, what we are dealing. From this we are going to know these all things, and even we have having a small problem on this, how the issue of shares come and how we call up the share capital, and final call, then subscription and the application fees and all the things, you will come to know exactly how it is. Okay, then further, see, I will dictate one more time because I don't want to create any of the doubts here, because two words are there in the issued capital. In this, two words will be coming. That is what issued and unissued, two words are there here. What issued capital means, I will tell you. It is a part of authorized capital. Yes, it is a part of this. It is a part of authorized capital. I mentioned here, it is a part of authorized capital, which is actually issued to the public for subscription. Now, for subscription of 10 rupees shares each, how much you are making? You are keeping 7 rupees, 2 rupees, 4 rupees, 5 rupees. It depends on you, how you are going to make the subscription for the shares. Then, subscriptions, including the shares allotted to the vendors and the signatories of the company's memorandum. Now you will be saying that we are going to allot 10,000 equity shares of rupees 10, this much, or else 1 lakh equity shares of rupees 10, means 1 crore you can get. This kind of calculation means, this is what just an example I am giving you all. This share capital, this many shares you are issuing for rupees 10 or 100 to your budget, the capital is, what capital requirement is 1 crore for that. Then further, the authorized capital which is not offered, now the authorized capital which is, this is what the capital which is not offered, means half of you are collecting and half not, means it is called as unauthorized capital, which is not offered for subscription. Subscription if you are not doing, matlab aap subscribe nahi karke le rahe hain, to wo unissued bolenge use. Kya bolenge? Unissued capital bolenge use. Theek hai, agar aap subscription nahi le rahe hain to use unissued bolenge, agar aap le rahe ho to use issued capital bolte hain. Itna hi hai. Next one, subscribed capital. Now what this subscribed capital, see, this is what we are going to see, what this subscribed capital means. See, it is again the part of the issued capital. Now again, what you have discussed here, it is part of it. This will, where it is, this is the part of this, part of this subscribed capital is a part of this. Means this, in numbers I will write, this is first, this is second, this is third, fourth, five, six, and seven. So, subscribed capital is a part of issued capital here. So, what it means here? Subscribed capital is a part of issued capital which has been actually subscribed by the company. What it is? Whatever you are issuing the capital, that has to be subscribed by the people. Okay. When it is subscribed by the people, we called it as a subscribed capital. When they subscribe for you, as everyone sees the YouTube channels, when you subscribe, the capital means you are following them. That is what generally out of syllabus I'm telling you all, it is what you are following them, that company. Now here we are talking about the company means you are linked with them, you are following them. Then see, subscribed capital is a part of issued capital which has been actually subscribed by the public. When shares are offered by for public subscription fully by the public, the issued capital and the subscribed capital will be same. When the issued capital and subscribed capital will be same. Now whole amount for 10 rupees you have issued 10 rupees capital issue of equity shares of rupees 10 rupees each, then whole amount is been collected at once. Whole 10 rupees amount is collected as once, means subscription capital and issued capital will be same. We call both the capitals as same. Got the things? How the things are linked to see. When you are issuing, this is what the second point is, when you are issuing 10 of shares of equity shares of rupees 10 each, then they have subscribed for you. For 10 rupees they have purchased. That time, these two will be the same. When you are subscribing, you are paying for them. These two are the same here. Okay. Then coming forward to the capital, called up capital. See, if you all are having any doubts regarding this, what I am telling these two points, point it out. Soon after our class time, I will end up with this fast and raise the questions that time. Okay. Then further, called up capital means what? See, it is a part of subscribed capital. Then again, this called up capital is a part of subscribed capital. How much subscribers are there? How many people have subscribed to purchase your shares? That matters here. Then how it is? Called up capital. It is a part of subscribed capital which has been called up for the shares. The company may decide to call the entire amount or part of the face value of shares. Now that only what I was giving the example here. See, called up capital means what? You can subscribe the whole amount. This is what? 10 rupees each. You can subscribe and collect whole amount at once, or you can collect only the 7 rupees called up. See, I am telling you all what is called up capital means what? However you require the capital, you can collect at once only, or how much is required at present, you can collect that much and remaining you can keep for the further. This is what the called up capital means. It is part of the subscribed capital. Now let us consider 2 lakh equity shares are there and subscribers are 2,50,000. Example, 2 lakhs equity shares you are going to publish in the market, but the subscribers are 2,50,000. Now remaining 50,000 subscribers, you will be rejecting them, removing out, and whatever you are subscribing them, you will call them for how much rupees? Now 10 rupees each it is. You can call whole amount of 10 rupees. If you don't require whole amount, you call for 7 rupees called up capital. You can call for 7 rupees, just how much is required at present, that much you can call up. And remaining you can keep as a reserve. In future, however the requirement comes, that time you can collect it. That is what the point here. We call here as a called up capital. Then next one, paid up capital. See what the paid up capital means. In the portion of that called up capital which has been actually received from the shareholders, when the shareholders have paid up all the call amount, the called up capital is same as the paid up capital. Now see, this is much interesting concept. How I will tell you. Now called up capital, if it is wholly called, whole amount if it is called, it will be the paid up capital. If you are calling the whole amount, 10 rupees each you are calling. Now each shares are being called up with 10 rupees. This paid up capital and called up capital will be the same. If you are not calling whole amount, if you are calling 7 rupees called up capital, you are calling only 7 rupees as a called up capital, that time remaining amount, those who have not subscribed, means for example, as I was telling you about 2 lakh equity shares you are going to publish, and then your applications have got 2,50,000, you have rejected 50,000 from them. Now out of that 2,02,000 people have not paid up capital, then what it is? That amount, we call it as a call in arrears. That wordings, remember this, call in arrears. If they have subscribed but not paid, subscribed but not paid the capital, call in arrears. I'll mention here. What it is? Call in arrears, yes. Call in arrears, we call this when it is not paid. I will tell you what exactly it means. See, paid up capital is a portion of called up capital. It is portion of called up capital which has been actually received from the shareholders. Now these things we are going to receive from the shareholders. When the shareholders paid the called amount, the called up capital is same as the paid up capital. What, how much they have called? For example, 10 rupees they have called. That only I am repeating one more time. 10 rupees they have called in the called up, the paid up capital will be the same. So I am telling you all, these two things will become same if it is fully called. If not, then I will tell you. If not, further see, if any shareholders has not paid amount on call, such amount will be called as call in arrears. That's what's here, amount. We have called up the share capital to pay 10 rupees or 7 rupees. Okay, first in the subscription time you have taken 7 rupees. See how we can get with link with this. Now so while subscribing we took how much? 7 rupees. And we have called up for 3 rupees. Okay, out of the example 2 lakhs equity shares, what I took the example, in that 2000 have not paid, 2000 for 3 rupees, 2000 have not paid. Now the amount of this will be 6000. This will be the nothing but calls in arrears, means yet the amount has to come to us is how much here? Call in arrears is how much here? 6000. That's it. In this paid up capital we get calls in arrears also, which after the subscription they have not paid the amount, we call them as a call in arrears. Then further, uncalled capital. Now what it uncalled capital means? See, that portion of the subscribed capital which has not yet been called up, as stated earlier, the company may collect the amount anytime in the future need, future funds. That now see, as we are taking here the calculation, we have issued 10 rupees each share and we have called up only 7 rupees, and these 3 rupees we have kept for further use in future. Whenever we required, we will take this 3 rupees. Whenever we require, that required in future, what we will take, that is what uncalled capital. In future, we will take when it is required. Matlab kya, hum logo ne subscribe kiya hai 10 rupay se, uske baad pura amount nahi liya. Kitna 7 rupay se liya hai. Aur hum logo ne baad mein ye jo pending amount hai, future mein lenge, ऐसे रखा है, उसे हम लोग क्या कहते हैं? अनकॉल्ड कैपिटल. मतलब जब भी हमें जरूरत होगी तब हम लोग ये अमाउंट बुलाएंगे या फिर फाइनल कॉल करेंगे, ठीक है, इतना ही। देन लास्ट पॉइंट आई विल टेल यू, लास्ट पॉइंट ऑफ दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, रिजर्व कैपिटल। दिस व्हाट रिजर्व कैपिटल। नाउ व्हाट रिजर्व कैपिटल मीन्स, रिजर्व मीन्स स्टोरिंग, एवरीवन नोज दैट रिजर्व मीन्स टू स्टोर। नाउ हियर अ कंपनी में रिजर्व अ पोर्शन ऑफ इट्स अनकॉल्ड कैपिटल टू बी कॉल्ड ओनली इन द इवेंट्स ऑफ वाइंडिंग अप ऑफ द कंपनी और अनकॉल्ड अमाउंट एज अ रिजर्व कैपिटल। सी द कंपनी में रिजर्व सम पार्ट ऑफ अमाउंट वेन एवर इट रिक्वायर्स, दे कैन कॉल अप, मीन्स अनकॉल्ड हाउ इट इज लिंक्ड, वेन एवर इट रिक्वायर्स दे कैन कॉल अप, इफ आई रिक्वायर सम मोर कैपिटल आई कैन मेक अ फाइनल कॉल फॉर देम सब्सक्राइबर्स। और एल्स टू थिंग्स वी कैन यूज योर, वॉट इज रिजर्व मीन्स वॉट, वाइल वाइंडिंग अप द कंपनी दैट टाइम ऑल्सो वी कैन कॉल दिस, और एल्स वेन एवर वी रिक्वायर वाइल रनिंग द बिजनेस और कंपनी दैट टाइम ऑल्सो वी कैन कॉल। सो मेक इट क्लियर टू अंडरस्टैंड, अ कंपनी में रिजर्व अ पोर्शन ऑफ इट्स अनकॉल्ड कैपिटल टू बी कॉल्ड फॉर द इवेंट्स ऑफ वाइंडिंग अप ऑफ द कंपनी, क्लोजिंग डाउन द कंपनी दैट टाइम यू कैन कॉल अप, और सच अमाउंट इज कॉल्ड एज रिजर्व कैपिटल ऑफ द कंपनी। सी वाइल कैलकुलेटिंग इन द बैलेंस शीट जनरल रिजर्व विल बी मैंशनड इन दाइब्रेरी, वॉट इज लाइबिलिटीज साइड्स, राइट, दैट इज वॉट द पार्ट फॉर वॉट पर्पज इट इज केप्ट, रिजर्व 2 लाख रुपीज और 1 लाख रुपीज, 50,000, वॉट एवर इन द बैलेंस शीट ऑफ ईच कंपनीज, वॉट एवर इट इज बीन मैंशन दैट वी कैन सी, दैट इज द थिंग, दैट्स द पॉइंट ऑफ योर, दैट्स इट। नाउ दीज ऑल थिंग्स, वॉट आर द कैटेगरीज आर देर, यू नो राइट नाउ वॉट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, वॉट इट इज ऑथराइज, देन इशूड, देन सब्सक्राइब्ड, कॉल्ड अप, पेड अप, देन अनकॉल्ड, रिजर्व एंड इवन दिस वर्ड कॉल्स इन अरियर्स, दिस वी कैन सी बाय टेकिंग वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल। ओके, इफ यू ऑल आर हैविंग एनी ऑफ द डाउट्स प्लीज मार्क इट एंड राइट इट ऑन वन ऑफ द पेपर सो दैट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास टुमारो वेन एवर आई एंगेज द क्लास दैट टाइम यू आस्क मी। ओके, जस्ट नाउ आई विल जस्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन दिस क्वेश्चन, जस्ट वी विल फ्रेम वन ऑफ द अकाउंट हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट इट एग्जैक्टली, हाउ मच टाइम, 10 to 15 मिनट्स वी आर हैविंग नाउ, जस्ट आई विल ट्राई टू कवर दिस। शैल आई इरेज दिस, विच एवर पॉइंट्स इफ यू ऑल आर हैविंग जस्ट मेंशन द पॉइंट्स नेम्स इन योर नोटबुक और पेपर सो दैट यू कैन रेज द पॉइंट्स इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास, फाइन। नाउ आई विल बी रीडिंग वन ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम द एग्जाम्पल, प्लीज रिमेंबर द थिंग्स, आई विल रीड बिट फास्ट, जस्ट वॉट एवर हैज टू बी रिटर्न आई विल टेल यू वॉट थिंग्स शुड बी केप्ट। ओके, सी हियर, लेट अस टेक द फॉलोइंग एग्जाम्पल, शो हाउ द शेयर कैपिटल विल बी शोन इन द बैलेंस शीट सनराइज। सी हियर आई एम टेकिंग द एग्जाम्पल, लिसन प्रॉपरली, विच पॉइंट्स हैज टू बी केप्ट, टेक वन पेन एंड पेपर एंड राइट इट, विच पॉइंट्स हैज टू बी केप्ट आई विल टेल यू। सी, सनराइज कंपनी लिमिटेड न्यू दिल्ली हैज रजिस्टर्ड कैपिटल ऑफ रुपीज 40 लाख, हाउ मच कैपिटल इट इज, कैपिटल ऑफ रुपीज 40 लाख, जस्ट राइट देर कैपिटल ऑफ रुपीज 40 लाख डिवाइडेड इन टू 4 लाख शेयर्स ऑफ रुपीज 10 ईच, डिवाइडेड इन टू हाउ मच, 4 लाख शेयर्स ऑफ रुपीज 10 ईच, 4 लाख्स इंटू 10 इट विल बी 40 लाख्स अमाउंट। देन द कंपनी ऑफर्ड टू द पब्लिक फॉर द सब्सक्रिप्शन इज 2 लाख शेयर्स ऑफ रुपीज 10, नाउ कंपनी इज गोइंग टू ऑफर ओनली 2 लाख शेयर्स ऑफ रुपीज, हाउ मच, रुपीज 10, मीन्स हाउ मच इट विल बी, दैट विल बी कैलकुलेटिंग फर्दर, मीन्स नियरली 2 लाख्स इंटू 10 मीन्स 20 लाख्स ऑफ इश्यूड कैपिटल वी विल बी गेटिंग। देन फर्दर 10 ईच फॉर एज एप्लीकेशन 2 रुपीज दे आर कॉलिंग, हाउ दे आर कॉलिंग, सी फॉर एप्लीकेशन इट इज 2 रुपीज, देन फॉर अलॉटमेंट 3 रुपीज, फॉर एप्लीकेशन इट इज 2 रुपीज, अलॉटमेंट 3 rupees. Then one more. First call 3 rupees. Application 2, allotment 3, then first call 3. Then the balance in on final call. The balancing will be called in final call. Then the company received application of 2,50,000. As I was telling you all, 2 lakh you are going to subscribe this equity shares, but the applications are how much? 2,50,000 shares. The company finalized the allotment of 2 lakh shares and reject 50 lakhs shares. Means 2,50,000, nearly 2 lakhs you are going to collect, but application is 2,50,000. Now 50,000 will be rejected and 2 lakh will be taken into consideration. Then further, the company received all the amount expect 2,000 shares which were called money has not been received. Now out of 2 lakhs they have called whole of the amount. How much the amount they have called? 2 rupees subscription, 3 rupees allotment, and 3 rupees, how much? 3 rupees will be the first call. Total how much? 2, 3, 5, 5 plus 3, how much? 8. 8 rupees they have called up. Then further, at last, the above amount will be shown in the notes of the account of the balance sheet of the Sundry Company Limited. Now how we are going to see here? See, Sunrise Company Limited. Okay, in this we are going to make only one-sided account. One side means which? This side here. Only we are going to show here the liability side. Just a note of account. We can call here as a note of account also. See, share capital. Share capital is how much here? In the question, have you all anyone pointed out the amount which I have told you? Share capital.
Yes, in, sir.
If you have noted out on the paper, it would be better. Just the amounts, what all things are there. Now, in the share capital, the authorized, in the first point, what we were discussing, the authorized capital, they have told in the memorandum of association that they are going to collect how much it is? 40 lakhs rupees. So here, authorized is how much? Authorized or registered? Or notional? Sorry, nominal. Nominal capital. It has been told directly 40 lakh. How much amount they are going to collect here in the share capital? Authorized capital is how much here? Registered or nominal capital is 40 lakhs.
40 lakhs.
Done. Then second, how much they have issued? Issued capital is how much now? Can you all guess it? 2 lakhs. 2 lakhs shares of rupees 100 each. Of rupees 100. Sorry, 10 rupees each. 10 each. Not 100. 10 each. How much it will be? 2 lakhs into 10?
20 lakhs.
20 lakhs. Done. Now, subscribed capital is how much? Subscribed capital. Now, as I have discussed one sentence, I will tell you. Only 5 minutes are remaining. I will wind up, see faster. I told you all, subscription of 2 lakh shares of rupees 10 each. Application 2 rupees. 2 rupees application plus. Then it is 3 rupees allotment. Okay. Then one more. First call is 3. How much it is? 6, 7, 8.
8.
8. Now here how you are going to calculate is subscribed. subscribed but not fully paid up. Subscribe but not fully paid up. 2 lakh shares of ₹10 each. Of ₹10 each, how much it is? ₹8 called up. Called up is how much? ₹8. Now 8 into 2 lakh, how much it will be straightforwardly?
16 lakhs.
And one more, in that same center, it has been told what it has been at a last, the company received the amount, expect 2,000 shares were called amount. Called up means first call amount is how much here? See, this is what I told you, application. This is allotment. And this is call, first call. Now 2,000 have not sent, means ₹3, that what we call here is less call in arrears. Call in arrears, okay. Call in arrears. How we can calculate here? This 2,000 into 3, how much it will be?
6,000.
Okay. Minus this from this. 15,94,000. Yes.
15,96,000.
No, 94,000.
94,000.
So this is what? This much only. Just we are showing a note of accounts. This is what called as note of account. Just what we have discussed now in the part, what is subscribed capital, then what is issued capital, then subscribed, unsubscribed, then called up, then unpaid or paid up. These all points we have been framing here. In further, somewhere one more or two classes will be completing the theory part. One or two classes. Two classes will be completing theory part. Then we will start up with the journals, journal entries, and even we are having the problems of journal entries in this chapter. We will be passing the journal entries here. See, journal entries are based on this every points.